He says he's a scally, a man of the people and a hard man.
He's a man of the people, John, that's for sure. What he's done with paying for the tickets and the coaches for his fans to come down is nothing but special.
Proud of his area where he lives, and the fans respond in kind. He is becoming hugely popular. I just hope that fight against Anthony
from the same city, you know, it's such a rarity that it would be a travesty if it didn't happen.
Crawler with his own big engagement to come against Linares. Thereafter, who knows? Terry Flanagan, though, has got to get through this first against Fana. Derry Matthews watching on the far side of the ring there next to Frank Warren. And he knows exactly about what Flanagan brings to the ring.
But he's intelligent.
Derry gave a very good account of himself. He gave him a fight, didn't he? He won eventually pretty widely, did Flanagan, yeah. But Derry really gave him a scrap.
Well, when is he never, Derry Matthews? Having a scrap epitomises Derry Matthews' career. He gives his all every time he fights. He's never an easy fight for anyone. But Flanagan's a clever fighter. You know, he can be aggressive, but he's such a good boxer. Little movements in and out to give himself the right distance. Really clever.
South African champion Fana, a couple of these fans sporting a South African flag sitting directly behind us. So if he has any moment of success, I think it's fair to say that you'll hear all about it.
A good right hand there from Fana.
Flanagan's a hard case though, isn't he? Tough guy.
He is tough. But I think his boxing brain is the most impressive part of his makeup for me.
Quick reactions, always has been a mobile sort of fighter, but whether or not he can take the power of Flanagan if they actually get into the stage where his chin is tested, that remains to be seen. And a complaint from Flanagan that Fana was coming in using his head. Never actually lost his IBF title in the ring, you know. Quite a long time ago now, 2011, he last held his belt, and are his best days behind him. Quiet opening round.
Yeah, and obviously a round for Terry Flanagan. He's doing his bossed the pace and tried to push Flanagan around.
Steve Maylett and Bobby Rimmer in the Flanagan corner. It is on Box Nation. Words of Steve Maylett with Terry Flanagan. Flanagan, physically the taller man.
Brought his front foot a little bit closer now, Flanagan.
Sneak right hand from Fana, just got through. No damage done, though.
Yeah. Well, in the first round, Flanagan was keeping a safe distance and just touching the tiger. And now, started this round, just took a little bit of a bigger step with the front foot, just so he can maybe start punching through the target. You've got to slow Fana down, so you've got to hit him on the chest when he's moving to his right.
Fana with
that left hand.
Fana with the obvious problem of having to cope with the southpaw stance. An experienced fighter like such as he, he'll have come across it many times before, but nobody likes it.
And Flanagan always keeps that right foot on the outside as well, so it means it's hard for Fana to get that his jab into play effectively enough to dictate any of the pace or boss anything. So he's got to throw that right hand, just took a clip in the right hand there, did Fana off Flanagan.
Shots from Fana getting through and another nice straight right hand.
This higher pace that was going to suit Flanagan. He keeps his height. It's not a frantic pace, but you've got to keep it at a high pace. You would suspect the older man would struggle with that.
Looks very fit though, Fana, doesn't he?
Well, he looks in good shape.
So much more known about conditioning nowadays, though, than in years gone by. A lot of fighters in these lighter weights. Not so long ago, you sort of said that once they got past 30, they were pretty much at their sell-by date. Not so now. In the second round here, prior to this, he'd had 398 rounds, so this is his 400th. Sort of Brian Lara moment.
That's better from Flanagan, doubling up that jab, stepping in behind it as well.
Flanagan trying to bully him around, trying to work the body. Interesting round, and Fana had his moments there.
It's still a Flanagan round for me. I think he's the far the busier, dictating the pace. Just showing Fana there, counter-punching quite neatly after having to take some punches off Flanagan first, though.
You're throwing two punches and pulling him down because he's there. Get to the next angle, isn't it, again?
Flanagan, we've got a couple of rounds ahead, but second round was closer and Fana did find a way through with a couple of quality right hands. Jinder Singh in action tonight over in India, and fans of him will watch that fight, can watch that fight after the conclusion of this show. We'll not give away the result.
Oh, nice right hand there from Fana.
He's boxing quite nicely, Barry. He's working the southpaw well. A solid body shot from Flanagan.
You've got to come back with a hook there, Flanagan. When he throws the 1-2, that's where Fana's timing with the right hand. So if he stays in the pocket, rolls and comes back with the right hook, and he gets more success and stops Fana from jumping in with the attacks.
It was originally due to a fought last week, Terry Flanagan, on the postponed Tyson Fury bill.
Oh, good right hand again.
Fana's head coming in again, alarmingly.
But the right hand was a good shot. He dips the head low.
Good lead again. Nice shot from Fana. Left hand that time.
Oh, sort of a cagey, isn't it, at the moment?
Yeah, Flanagan's just finding him hard to tag.
Sits on the back foot, doesn't he, Fanner? Oh, nice little counter left there from Terry Flanagan.
I wonder whether Fanner is going to be able to really go the distance. Is he going to be able to stay with the pace of Flanagan as he increases the intensity?
The right hander as well of Fanner getting through.
Well, he had his moments, Fanner, once more. Success with the right hand. Did he do enough to take the round?
I think he did. You know, I think it was a close right hand. I think Flanagan picked up the pace in the latter half. I think those big long right hands from Fanner with the standout shots.
Steve Maylett wanting a little bit more urgency from Terry Flanagan. Interesting to know what that final exchange was just before he went out.
Imagine saying he's really, because he's no fan, is really awkward, isn't he? He sits on that back foot.
Oh, he's caught hand. Him there. Left hand on the temple, I think it was. He's protesting it wasn't a genuine knockdown. It looked it to me, though.
It was a short left hand, just come across the...
Well, it'll be interesting to see. Maybe he was complaining that there was a punch thrown after he'd gone down. I don't know. We'll have a look at that. And I think Steve Gray said something similar to Flanagan.
Just landed a good right hook as well there, Terry Flanagan. I think he clipped him. I think he clipped him and made him hit the floor. He was leaning forward, I think, Fanner, when he dived through with the head forward and with the right hand. So maybe off balance a bit, but he looked like he got clipped.
It was a genuine knockdown. There's no question about that. It's getting a bit rough in there now. See Frank Warren on the far side, urging Terry Flanagan forward to keep the pressure on.
Good right hand there from Flanagan.
Flanagan's cut, right eye, it's on the cheek. That's not going to be a factor, one would think, because the blood from that won't be going into his eye, but he is cut. Now, whether that's done by a punch, I suspect more likely it's been a clash of heads. It's a wonder to me that it's not happened before now, and Flanagan is really going looking for him. Terrific work rate from Flanagan, and Fanner, as the power and the speed of the attack has increased, has not been able to stay with him.
That cut doesn't look great. Even though it's underneath the eye, doesn't look great. A little bit of a panic there from Flanagan, maybe just smothering his work when he had Fanner on the ropes.
Warning him about using his arms to push his man away. And that cut does not look good.
Well, it's a mouse as well, isn't it? Just a little swelling as well with the cut.
Well, there'll be work for the corner. Bobby Rimmer in there. Frank Hopkins is the man who's going to be dealing with the cut. And he's got some work to be done. Now, was it a clash of heads or was it a punch that's caused the damage? That's something that we'll be looking at between the rounds.
That's good there from Flanagan. A little half a step back, making Fanner fall short with those jumping in with that right hand.
Fanner's recovered pretty well, though.
Well, you haven't let it bother him, to be fair, Flanagan. Just gone about his work. He's had a good round, Teddy Flanagan, except for the cut, he's had a really good round.
Well, that's going to be a 10-8 round. The knockdown was given. And now Frank Hopkins goes to work on the cuts, which does not look good. Now, is that where the clash of heads there?
There's a mark. Is it a mark already on his eye there? His hand itself.
Right hand came across there. Did that do damage? Another one there.
No, that's the wrong side of the face. That little whipping left hook, maybe.
Was it there? Was it the clash of heads there? Was that the moment? There.
Hard to see, isn't it?
At that point, the damage has been done.
Interesting to see what Steve Gray gave regarding the cut. Whether he said it was a clash of heads or a punch. That makes a massive difference if the cut gets worse.
That's given us a slip, no knockdown.
Lucky there, though, because he did get caught with a punch. Now, whether you slip or not, you got caught with a punch.
We'll have a look at the knockdown again, if it goes past the end of this round. It was a left hand which did the damage. Looks as though they've done a good job on that facial injury.
Yeah. Two good right hands there from Fana. Again, it's the same punch from Fana every time.
A wily old fighter is giving a bit of a blueprint as to how to deal with the southpaw with that right hand.
I think he's lucky there, Fanning, again, because it's the uppercut that puts him off balance.
Really lunges in, reaches in behind his punches, doesn't he?
Well, he has success sometimes with a long right hand. You said he jumps into it, but then he leans foot, and that's where when Flanagan's catching him, whether it hurts or not, he's hitting him off balance.
There's a good left hand there from Flanagan, put him into reverse gear, and Flanagan walked pretty much straight onto it.
Can't miss him with the uppercut, isn't he, Terry Flanagan? Every time he throws that left uppercut,
well, you think that's going to be the one which is going to sort this one out, don't you?
Just needs to whip a real fast right hook over the top when he throws that left uppercut. Just twist from the waist, just turn and turn with the punches. Good again.
Pretty difficult to tag down though, isn't he, to get clean, Fana?
Yeah, he's a fidgety little style, hasn't he, Fana? But Flanagan, I think he's got the range in the last couple of rounds, Teddy Flanagan.
Defensive work again on the ropes from Fana. Initial left hand got through, but nothing thereafter.
No, it's all Flanagan at the moment. The only thing that Fana has really is that jumping in right hand. He dips the head low and just flies in with the punch. That's all he's got going for him at the moment. Oh, lovely jab there. Again there from Flanagan, who's putting a lot of pressure here on Fana, making him work hard. That's the right tactic against the older man.
Fifth round complete. Flanagan not looking too happy with life as he goes back to his corner. A little bit frustrated. Let's take a look again at the knockdown in the fourth round. Well, he kind of catches him on the neck, doesn't he?
Well, that's a shot there. That's a cracking shot.
He did throw a punch when he was on the ground.
He did, though, but that shot there, that's a knockdown every day of the week.
I don't really see what the argument was. It was pretty conclusive.
Look at the cracking shot. But again, it's because Fana leans too far over the front foot and has no balance to take the shot.
Slide down. sixth round. Farnham is down in the fourth. And Flanagan well ahead on points. On Burry's card, the only round that he's given to Farnham so far was the third.
I think it's been a pretty, I wouldn't say massively dominant performance from Flanagan, but he's been in everything. And the last few rounds especially have been, for the cut, have been relatively comfortable for Terry Flanagan.
Farnham's got what? An herky-jerky kind of style.
Yeah. Oh, good right hand there again from Flanagan. He throws something up from awkward angles. Even then, he was close in. Didn't think there was anything to land with. He throws a looping right hand over the top.
For an old lad, he's quick, isn't he?
Yeah, he's elusive enough, but all he's showing is to be a tricky, hard opponent to hit.
Referee having a word with Flanagan. And Farnham. Farnham ducking low, Flanagan dragging him lower.
Yeah, pushing on the back of the neck is obviously not low, but if Farnham is going there, well, Farnham's going low. And a sharp right hook there from Flanagan again. I mean, Flanagan just keep that bounce in his step, keep Flanagan under pressure.
Good job.
And just let go with the combinations, rattle them off. I don't think you want to throw single punches against Flanagan, you've got to throw in threes and fours.
Still getting a bit of success as he leaps in behind that right hand, Flanagan. Oh, that's a good shot. It's an awkward sort of night for Flanagan, who's a little bit frustrated, you sense.
Yeah, well, he's missing a lot. He's missing more than he's used to. And I think that's a frustrating part for him. But he's winning the wrongs, and he's just got to keep sticking to the plan. Keep trying to put pressure on this guy, hoping he starts to fade. But I think the tempo got to be a bit higher for me from Terry Flanagan.
Flanagan's having some success in this round again with the right hand.
Lovely there from Fana.
And again, boxing beautifully.
Just took his foot off the gas a little bit in this round, Terry Flanagan.
Fana's two South African fans sitting behind us are starting to get a bit more animated. Not sure it's coming across on our commentary microphones. They sense that their man is getting into it. That's a much better round for Fana.
Yeah, might have done enough to nick that round, you know, with the cleaner punches.
Behind on our card, and Zonky Fana. But doing enough to show in that last round that he's far from WBO world title fight at lightweight. Terry Flanagan defending his crown.
Cut again there from Flanagan.
I tell you what, Barry, if it weren't for that knockdown, which Fana protested about for whatever reason, if it weren't for that knockdown, this would be very close.
But I think, you know, you can, by watching the fight as a whole, you think that Flanagan's winning the fight, and clear enough, maybe. It's been frustrating for him, that's all. I just think he needs to keep, you know, follow through with the combinations. When he throws that uppercut, right hook, and then a straight right hand or left hand after. Right, so he's left uppercut, right hook, straight left, and just finish the combinations off. single punches against this guy, a good mover, it's not going to be enough. It might be enough to win, but not enough to win clear and clean. Just don't want to give this guy any more confidence than he already has. Put him in his place, keep it a high work rate, rattle off the combinations, put him under pressure. That's good there for Flanagan. And good footwork as well. Little feint there from Flanagan he needs. Feint, draw the lead and then throw the 1-2.
Our next fight in the ring tonight, Guillermo Rigondo, World Super Bantamweight title defence against the Liverpudlian Jazza Dickens, coming up next for you. Liam Williams against Gary Corcoran, British and Commonwealth Super Welterweight title. That brings the... Thereafter, it's off to India for Vijender Singh.
Set a tremendous pace, just enough.
Good right hand again from Fana.
Oh, nice little right hand there from Flanagan, picking him off now.
Pull his way back on top, Flanagan.
You've got to be careful of that pulling of the head though there, Flanagan. There's no need for that. If he's doing well, just letting his hands go. A good round there, Flanagan.
Yeah, last minute was emphatic, wasn't it?
Yeah, he established control again.
Done a pretty good job on that cut. Years of experience going into working on that cut. Frank Hopkins, very much a respected practitioner of the art.
Yeah, he's brilliant. And Bobby Roomer in the corner as well, so you know, full of experience there.
Oh, great shot, left hand. How on earth did Fana stay up there? Somehow managing to stay on his feet, but Flanagan now is looking to take him out. It was a huge left hand which landed absolutely flush, and momentarily it looked as though Fana was going to go. How did he stay upright?
Tremendous. He really looked like he was going to fall backwards, didn't he? But showing that resolve, that's taking him to world titles before. But Flanagan got plenty of time now in this round. Just keep the pressure on with that front foot. And don't get too close, don't smother your work now.
Well, we said it was the left hand bringing it up which was going to cause the trouble, and that was what happened.
And again with the left hand there, straight one this time from Flanagan.
With every second that passes, Fana regroups though.
Bang a jab to his chest, stop him, then throw that uppercut from Flanagan. Stop that upper body movement, stop that, make him slippery, just bang him in the chest, stops him still, and then whack that left hand through.
Flanagan just waiting for Fana to commit himself, waiting for him to jump in, as is his wont.
Thank you.
Looked like a great opportunity to finish that fight, and he's not been able to do so. Still a minute to go nearly, though.
Cut there again with the left hand from Flanagan. Over 50 seconds to go, this is where he should be starting to... ...on Fana.
Looking for the big left hand.
Just a fidgety style that Fana has, it's just stopped Flanagan from overcommitting, and it's kept Fana in the wrong, let's be honest, kept him in the fight.
Doesn't do a great deal, does he? Sort of has a hypnotic effect, though.
Yeah, he's always a moving target, so you're never sure to unload, you've got to try and time it right. So, because he sneaks a few counters in as well, he just keeps you on your toes.
Well, Fana survives and caught again right on the bell. With a terrific right hand, left hand, both straight punches and both bang on target.
Best round so far there from Teddy Fana. That one, that little as well, was brilliant. Really hurt Fana. Again, it's been the uppercut that he hadn't been able to miss with.
Well, how he stayed up from that, I do not know.
Tremendous resolve that is from Fana. Look at, even his eyes were rolling in the back of his head.
And he caught him right on the bell, again, didn't he? That's a terrific punch.
Flanagan, and Flanagan didn't rush in, try and go too crazy and finish him off. And maybe, I thought that was sensible, maybe that was a mistake, because Fana, you know, recovered well.
Well. Right at the end of the round, Flanagan again landed two really good shots. Look at that, right hand particularly really. Was a peach.
That's textbook stuff there from Flanagan. A little half a step out and then stepping in with a nice sharp 1-2.
For Flanagan, now surely he knows that the fight is his.
Full of energy now though, Terry Flanagan.
We'll be looking to finish it now, Barry. It's been an awkward night for him.
Yeah, it has.
Surprise. A bit more difficult. A little bit harder than I thought.
I still did either, but you know, Fana's been a good fighter. He thought his best days were way behind him, and Flanagan has had such a good run, and on paper some really hard fights, and done tremendously well in all of them, you know, from the Stephen Allman fight up until then the Cepeda, the Magdaleno, and then that good win against Matthews. You thought this was going to be a relatively easy night for him.
He's looking for him again.
It hasn't been a hard fight for him, it's just been a frustrating night for him, that's all. But I think the last few rounds, especially, I think, you know, from round 5 and then round 7 and 8, they've been really good for Flanagan.
And not a big puncher, so you suspect he doesn't have the real power in that right hand to turn it around. Good jab that was from Flanagan. Was with the power. And Flanagan right into it.
Straight 1-2 again.
And he's in danger. I tell you, he's going to lose a point if he's not careful.
He is, and I don't think he's done too much wrong there, to be honest, on that occasion. Just the fact that he's done it so often, pushing down on the back of the neck. Anything remotely looking like that, then he's going to get warned for it.
Caught him with a little left hand there, Flanagan. Still can't get him into the position to deliver the real power shot which might end it.
You got to aim a little bit lower with a straight shot there, Flanagan. Fana just dipping below him. Aim for the chest.
Fana's recovered well. Now here comes Flanagan once more. Still not finding a clean shot in this attack. Good defensive work from Fana. last few seconds of the round, which will be another Terry Flanagan round.
It's another clear round for Terry Flanagan, but it's also another frustrating round for him because he feels that he could get the finish and he just can't trap Flanagan, when he gets on the ropes, can't trap him enough, can't hit him clean and often enough because Flanagan's moving ahead pretty well, doing his best to evade shots.
6 points advantage now we have.
Get back at him. He landed a clean shot, get back at him earlier.
Just
don't come your work, yeah, on the road. Not hit no angles yet either, have you?
We all know how fit Flanagan is, you know, he's extremely fit. So he can box at a high pace. So that's what he needs to do now. Three rounds. That's good. Oh, Lucan shots hurt him again there with that left hand, Flanagan.
Legs just stiffened momentarily, Fana. You really do get the feeling that one quality shot here could be enough to finish this.
But you think he's hurt him, and he looks and he sort of leans back, or his balance looks doesn't look the best, Fana, but then he seems to be fine.
Well, how he recovered from that shot in the eighth, I really don't know. It was one of absolutely on the button from Flanagan, and somehow Fana not only took it, but the round was walked into a couple of the last exchange, but he was fully recovered pretty
much. Was. Again, you've got to keep that tempo high, just slow down the pace a little bit there, Fana. He slowed the pace down and gives himself a little bit of rest. Flanagan will keep the high tempo all the time. Just popping around him on the balls of his feet, plenty of feints before he attacks. Good shot.
A fair few people thought Fana was going to be blown away here. And here we are. Into the closing stages of the 10th round. Defence for Flanagan on paper. It's supposed to show in boxing, you never really quite know.
No, you don't. And he's been in a fight, relatively easy, and the scorecard's going to be quite big, you would feel, but he's looked a little bit flat. Flanagan. I don't know whether that's because Fana's so awkward, maybe, or maybe because, you know, the change of date and venue and everything else with the fight being moved, maybe that's had an effect, who knows. Because he hasn't boxed terrible, Flanagan, but I think he could be, I was expecting a higher energy performance from him. Which we know he's capable of.
Are you saying you've been a bit...
It's not a bad performance, but you know, he's had some scintillating performances of late, so maybe I am a little bit. Lovely 1-2 there though from him again.
Yeah, clipped him, with that,
looking
left,
hurt
clipped
and just,
him with that left hand, and again just staggered momentarily, but the bell goes to end. Another 3 minutes when Flanagan can't quite tag his man, but another round
and he's winning everything quite, and the second half of the fight he's won everything quite comfortable, let's be honest. But I think he's a better fighter than what we're seeing. And I think he could control the pace better against Fana to put him under more pressure. And then he would have, in my opinion, got the stoppage a lot earlier.
Only 6 minutes remaining. The 11th round begins. Terry Flanagan defending his WBO lightweight world title. And a long way ahead on our scorecard. Had his man down, remember, in the fourth. And round seven. All rounds. Second half of the. Reactions not quite what they were a few rounds ago, not surprisingly. 42 years old.
Yeah, and he's been put under a lot of pressure the last, especially the second half of the fight. Nice right hook there from Flanagan, following up with a straight 1-2 again.
As the edge has gone off the movement of Fana, so Flanagan has been able to get through with his boxing skills, which were frustrated in the first half of the fight. Clipped him with the right hand coming in, Flanagan.
He's been a hard man to hit, but he's been a hard man to hit clean. I mean, that's been the difference. And Flanagan's found it quite easy to land the shot clean enough to put him a bit of a struggle. And when he has hit him clean, I think Flanagan's shown a pretty good resilience to.
He's a tough old boy.
And just landed a nice good 1-2 there himself there, fan on the pipe.
Nice straight left hand from Flanagan. Looking as though it's going to go the distance now.
You could just see the frustration in Flanagan's face then when the referee broke him. Again, you see it there, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
Everything about it just, you know, like it feels lethargic, and that's a lot to do with.
The Anthony Crolla fans watching this, those who believe that he's the main man in the lightweight division in the UK, they'll say, maybe Flanagan, this has shown he's not quite as good as some people think.
Of course, they watch this and fancy it, because they'll see things that he hasn't done and things that he could have done and thought, you know, they could exploit it. Oh, that's good. That's good.
Nice flurry of shots right on the bell. And he walks back to his corner just a little bit, well, not disconsolately, but he's not exactly got a spring in his step, has he? So just 3 minutes remaining. Is Fana going to give it one big last go? Flanagan a mile in front, surely.
You would expect him just be the same as the last six rounds or five rounds, really. It'd be Flanagan dominating everything, and Fana just trying to pot shot with the right hand.
If you're a promoter, you wouldn't be wanting to make the rematch, would you? Good left hand in there from Flanagan.
Well, that's the first of the land with more than targets consecutively. Good jab there from Fana.
Again, frustration from Flanagan. I suspect that when he speaks to Steve Bunce after the fight, Flanagan's going to speak about.
I think that's what it's been, but you know, on my card, I think if he presumably wins this round, that's 10 out of 12 rounds that he's won. And, you know, in a world title fight, you take that every day. Body. We've seen him better, we've seen him produce better displays. I think Fana, who by the way, is a former world champion, two-time world champion, has proved to be, you know, the experience and the elusiveness, the awkwardness of being able to hit him clean.
You can see why he was good enough to become a world champion. Take eight, 9 years out of him, and then he's, you know, you've got this, only better and more agile and faster
more
and snappy.
More energy and more, and more adventurous maybe in his attacks.
Good shot.
Good knockdown.
And again, he says it's not a knockdown, but it's been given. The right hand did it, I think.
Does Flanagan jump on him now?
Does Flanagan think it was a genuine knockdown? I'm not sure. There's a little touch of gloves there before the action resumed, which makes you wonder. Now Flanagan is looking to provide the spectacular finish. And Fana is having to absorb quite a lot. Manages to get away, work his way along the ropes. Referee keeping a close look at him.
Just got to keep throwing punches now, Flanagan. Fana's spent. I don't think he's seriously hurt, but he's spent. He's knackered.
Flanagan bullying him back. Last 30 seconds.
That's good for Flanagan there, spinning around the target, landing shots.
Oh, and again.
Too late, I think, to get the stoppage.
Mouth starting to look busted up now, Fana. And he's gone the distance, but has lost by a long, long way. Flanagan having him down in the 12th round for his second 10-8 round, and he is still the WBO World Lightweight Champion, of that I am absolutely certain. Had to fight for much of the fight with the handicap of that damaged right eye, but he came through ultimately winning very, very emphatically.
He did, you know, he dominated, you know, almost all of the fights. He's only cut the rounds I gave the Fana, and they weren't conclusive in his favour either. So, you know, in that respect, it's been a good night's work, but we've seen Flanagan, we think he knows he could have produced better than that. I think he could have got the stoppage a few times, but Fana was awkward, the hit clean.
Here's the knockdown in the last round.
That's lovely. That's just good technique, that is. That's more than power, that's just really good technique. Hitting him right on the button, right square.
He was off balance, wasn't he? And you can understand Fana's frustration, but that is a genuine knockdown.
Yeah. And the engine's always good at Flanagan. He finished the fight stronger than he started him. Anyway, I just think he could. We know how fit he is. If you were the boxer at a higher tempo to start the fight, put this guy under pressure early. But all in all, winning 10 out of 12 rounds, which I have it, and a couple of them with the knockdown as well, is a very good night's work.
Fana made life awkward in the early stages, possibly even nicked a couple of rounds in the first six. But the back end of the fight belonged to the younger man, as we suspected it would do. Terry Flanagan, dominant in the end. That last round knockout merely emphasising the fact. Mark Burdis is poised centre ring, and we can now go into the ring, I think, to get the verdict. Flanagan doesn't look particularly happy with what's happened in there, but surely he is about to be announced as the champion. We can now go to Mark Burdis.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, scorecard, a unanimous decision. All three judges have scored the contest 120 to 106. The winner, and still the WBO Lightweight Champion of the World, Chester.